Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's GTA video, we're going to be talking about a lot of interesting things about GTA 6, including some people apparently talking to Rockstar employees about when it's going to be coming out, if it's in development, and more. We'll dive into that, as well as a couple of other interesting topics as well. Now, before we get into that, over the last couple of days, you might have seen this image floating around. This is another leaked photo of the PlayStation 5 development kit. What's funny is actually behind it on the right hand side, you can see what the PlayStation 4 development kits look like. And this is cool because this is what GTA 6 is likely being developed on right now. Now, if you guys are wondering, will this be the final product? Obviously, the answer to that is no. The dev kits look tremendously different than the retail versions that the consumers get their hands on. But regardless, this is cool because this is a confirmation that the leaks we've seen in the past are pretty much legit. And it's just neat because this is what GTA 6 is likely being built on right now at the Rockstar Games offices. So I found that to be kind of cool. That is, again, PS5 dev kit right there. Anyways, let's move on. Over the last couple of days, there's been some users on the GTA 6 subreddit that have been trying to get in contact with some Rockstar employees, whether that's through LinkedIn or through their art portfolios. I'll leave links to all the sources in the description so you can check them out for yourself. And this is what they posted. Now, their names and their profile pictures have been blurred out, I think for privacy's sake. But this is what those individuals had to say. So someone asked, "I understand the studio began the hiring process of testers about a month or so ago. I'm just a little curious to know, is this for a new title such as GTA 6, a sequel to Bully, or is this simply for online updates to already existing games such as Red Dead Redemption 2 and Grand Theft Auto 5? I understand those updates are getting much more attention recently." And apparently the Rockstar employee said, "Hey man, I think it's for 6 and online updates." And as sort of a follow-up to that, they said, "That's what I figured. That's what I've been hearing for the past months. Any word if Bully 2 is still in production?" And they said, "No, it's not." Okay, so right off the bat, I'm a little bit skeptical here. Number one, anyone could create like a LinkedIn page as like a fake Rockstar employee. In fact, someone could do that as me. Like they could create a fake, you know, Mr. Boss for the Win page and start replying to people. So you have to be careful, especially with stuff like this. Number two, I also would find it highly unlikely that an employee would just be giving out information like this to a random person that they're asked about online. But let's just assume that it is real. That's interesting, and it kind of confirms what we've expected all along, is that Rockstar is using game testers not only for Red Dead Online and GTA Online updates, but also for Grand Theft Auto 6 as well. Now, at what stage GTA 6 is in, I'm not sure. If I had to take a guess, and we'll actually look at this in a little bit, I would say it's pretty close to almost being done. Now, that doesn't mean it's going to come out anytime soon, but I would suspect for the most part the game is certainly playable and definitely like the majority of the game is already figured out. Now, what's also interesting is this same individual tried to contact another Rockstar employee, and they basically asked them the same situation. They said, "Hey, thanks for understanding the situation. Honestly, we have no information about Bully 2 yet, but hope for the best. Rockstar never makes its fans disappointed." And that individual said, "Thanks for the response back. I genuinely appreciate it. So I'm guessing the game that is getting tested is the next GTA installment after all." And they said, "Hey, brother, I am extremely sorry. I'm not supposed to say. You'll get to know very soon." So again, same thing here. Anyone could create a LinkedIn page, art portfolio, profile like this and essentially just respond to themselves or a friend that's on the other side. However, again, let's just assume it is true. That, of course, proves what we know so far and that GTA 6 is the game that is being tested right now. Now, with all of that in mind right there, a user on the GTA forum site, FelipeBorges388, created this really cool possible timeline for Rockstar for when we could see GTA 6. And you guys can see there that there's two scenarios. The first scenario here is more likely, which is no new game. And you can see that we are in December 2019. And basically, from this time until next year, holiday 2020, we'll be getting GTA Online updates, Red Dead Online updates. And he assumes that Red Dead Online would last a little bit longer than GTA Online just because it's so new. You can see that in holiday 2020, the next generation will launch. That is when he also suspects the last GTA Online update will come out. E3 is, of course, in the middle of the summer in 2021. That's when he believes Grand Theft Auto 6 will get an announcement and will launch in the fall of 2022. Now, if a new Rockstar Games comes out, pretty much the exact same thing starting in December 2019. However, in early 2020, that announcement might be something like Bully 2. Bully 2 would end up launching later that year in fall of 2020. And then everything else remains status quo, with GTA 6 getting announced in middle of 2021, with its launch in fall of 2022. The only big difference there is this individual believes they would see a Bully 2 remastered launch for the fall of 2021. Maybe that would be for like the PlayStation 5 and whatever Microsoft's Project Scarlet is going to be. Now again, that is just a possible timeline there, but it matches up not only with what I believe, but also what we've seen from previous leaks, reputable reports, and more, that the game is likely going to be launching around 2022. And if that is the case, that could be a pretty accurate timeline of what to expect. So some pretty cool stuff right there. That's a really cool graph from Felipe Borges. Now, another thing that's going on, you might have seen this floating around online the last couple of days. It's this video right here that looks like it was shot on an iPhone. And you guys can see there that this individual has Googled Rockstar Newswire GTA 6. And you can see there that sort of the preview for the Rockstar Newswire is, we are very proud to officially announce that Grand Theft Auto 6 is in full development. And then one of the links you can click on is Grand Theft Auto 6. So that's interesting, because if you were to go to the Newswire right now, that is not what you would see at all. You would see the latest GTA updates, Red Dead updates. Nothing about GTA 6 has been officially announced. And later on in the video, when this individual Googled PlayStation Store, it had details about Grand Theft Auto 6 and how you could get a PlayStation exclusive deal. And so a lot of people believed, okay, what is going on here? How come when I Google this stuff, I'm not getting those same results? Well, it actually turns out that that video right there has been debunked. And it's pretty easy to do something like this. I mean, I'm sure I couldn't figure it out. But it's basically just using Inspect Element on the iPhone. In fact, I'll even leave a link in the description that shows you how to do this stuff. It's pretty easy. As long as you can like connect your iPhone to your computer, it's something that most people can figure out. Now again, I'm not saying it's super easy, but if you wanted to just edit some text on an article, something that you could very easily do. So that's one of those things that you should not be fooled by right there, and that I think a lot of people have just because they see that video and they run with it. So that video right there that you might have seen floating around is indeed fake. Now the last thing we're going to discuss in this video today is something a lot of you guys have been asking me, and that is when Grand Theft Auto 6 arrives, what universe is it going to take place in? Now, we obviously know it's not going to be in the 3D era or the 2D era. The big question is it going to be in the HD era or something new like the UHD era, which would be Ultra HD? Or would Rockstar call it the 4K era? Now, the reason this is important is it might determine what characters can return. Remember, Rockstar has this weird rule where if you're not in the same generation, like characters can't return into that game. So for example, CJ from Grand Theft Auto San Andreas can't return in Grand Theft Auto 5. And for example, if GTA 6 was in the HD era and was in Vice City, Tommy Vercetti couldn't return because he is in the 3D era. So that's an interesting question to think about. I wonder how Rockstar will handle it. It honestly just might depend on the new consoles. Like if the PlayStation 5 and the Microsoft Project Scarlet are super powerful enough that, you know, even in sort of a default medium settings normal mode, you can still get it in 4K, they might officially transition to a new era. And if that's the case, that would eliminate all the characters we've seen from GTA 4 and its DLCs and Grand Theft Auto 5, meaning they would not be able to return, and we would only see all new characters. So just something interesting to think about. There isn't really any news surrounding that, but it is a question that I've been getting a lot recently, and it was one that I even had to kind of think about as well. Like, I wonder what Rockstar is really going to do here. But anyways, that's all the information that I've got for you guys in this video today. Hopefully you did enjoy. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Let me know what you think about everything we discussed in this video today and more. If you guys did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you want to stay up to date on all the latest GTA and Red Dead Redemption videos that I'm doing here on my channel. And be sure to ring that notification bell as well. Sometimes YouTube just doesn't work, and if you ring that bell, you'll always be guaranteed to be notified when new videos arrive. But of course, as always, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.